Hey guys, what's up? This is Manas, your friend and tutor, and I'm back with another video on engineering drawing. Well, this video series is going to be based on spirals, and I've planned 3 videos on it. Let me just give you a very brief account of all the 3 videos that are going to be uploaded. Well, it's going to take 3 to 4 days maximum. The first video is going to be all about giving you a general introduction as to what a spiral is, and then we'll also take a look at Archimedean spiral and the different terms associated with that. And we'll also do construction for one convolution and for two convolutions of an Archimedean spiral. Then in the second video, we'll learn the basics of a logarithmic spiral, and we'll learn, or rather I'll demonstrate to you how a logarithmic spiral can be made. And then in the final video, video 3, it's going to be all about how to put up tangent and normal at any given point on a spiral. So without further ado, let's kick off with this one, spirals. Now, before we go ahead and read the definition over here, let me first give you a demonstration, and it will be very easy to understand this thing. Here we go. This point O, let's say, is the pole, which is going to remain fixed, and there is going to be this point P, which is going to slide along this link. Okay. Now, let's say this link takes a rotation, let's say in the clockwise sense, by an angle of 45 degrees. What happens then? This point P, well, it achieves a new location, a new position, that is going to be P1. If the link rotates further, again, let's say by an angle of 45 degrees, the point moves further away from the pole, and the link keeps on rotating, the point keeps on moving further away and away and away, and finally it reaches the extreme right of the link, you can say, or the other end of the link. When you join all these points right from the start till this end in proper sequence with the help of a smooth curve, well, this is what you call a spiral. This red color curve is what is referred to as a spiral. It's as simple. Now you can go ahead and read this definition. It will be very, very easy for you to learn this. So a spiral is basically the locus of a point moving along a straight line, moving along a straight line. That's a straight line. It is moving along this straight line continuously in one direction. It is moving outwards, okay, or away from the pole, you can say. When the line rotates in a plane about one of its ends, obviously the screen on which you are watching this video is a plane, and all of this activity is happening on that screen, on that plane. But one thing that you need to remember, well, this could have been done in a different sense also. I initially took this point, rather I should say this pole and this moving point, this fixed point and this moving point, initially I considered them at the same point, or I considered them overlapping, you can say. And then as the link started rotating, the point kept moving further away. Well, we could have done this in a different sense. We could have taken this point P over here. In that sense, let's say we could have given this an anti-clockwise rotation, and this P7 would have become P1, P6 would have become P2. So clockwise or anti-clockwise really does not matter. Okay. Ultimately, you are going to get a spiral. So now let's move further, and let me give you some common terminology associated with spirals. Now this pole, it's the fixed point. Well, this O over here is what you refer to as a pole. What's a radius vector? Okay, it's the line joining any point on the curve with the pole. So let's say if I make a point over here, and let's call this point as, let's say, S. And if I join this S with the pole, then this line is what you refer to as, let's say OS is what you refer to as a radius vector. Cool, isn't it? What do we have next? Vectorial angle. Again, this is also very easy to understand if you have understood radius vector. Well, vectorial angle is very simple. It is the angle between the line at any time and its initial position. So this is the initial position, let's say. Let's say this is the initial position P. Okay. After some time, it has reached this point S. So the angle traversed, this angle theta over here, is what is referred to as the vectorial angle. It's as simple. So what about a convolution? It's very simple. Now the link has rotated one revolution. Okay. So listen to this very carefully. The curve traced out by the moving point for one revolution of the line is a convolution. Now for a spiral, there could be n number of revolutions. There could be two revolutions, and corresponding to which there will be two convolutions. in this particular demonstration, I've only gone for one revolution. That is why we've got one convolution. And this convolution is a spiral, nothing else. Now guys, let us talk about the classification of spiral, and they have been divided into two types. One of which is an Archimedean spiral and the other one is a logarithmic spiral. In this particular video, we'll be talking about Archimedean spiral, and the video which is going to be followed by this one is where I'll talk about a logarithmic spiral. So let's kick off with an Archimedean spiral. Let's see what it has in store. Here we go. Okay. Again, let me give you a demonstration, and pretty much it's going to be the same, but I'll add a few terms associated with this. Here we go. Point P, moving point. Point O, that is the pole about which the rotation happens. Link keeps on rotating. Point P starts moving away, 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 further away, and finally reaches the other end. When you join all these points, you have a spiral. But when am I going to call this spiral an Archimedean spiral? Well, there are some terms which are extremely important, and for that you need to listen to this very carefully. It is the locus of a point traced when a point is moving. Point is moving uniformly. This is an extremely important statement along a straight line. So the point has to move uniformly. That means it has to travel equal distances in equal intervals of time. For example, let's say between these two points, the distance is x. Then between this and this, the distance has to be 2x. Between this and this, the distance has to be 3x. This has got to be 4x, isn't it? So in a way, you can say that the movement of the point is sort of following an arithmetic progression. Moving point P is sort of following an arithmetic progression. Moving point. So that's a mathematical property, right? Okay, either towards or away from the pole, as I told you. While the straight line revolves about the pole with uniform angular velocity. Now this is also interesting. So initially it has traveled a distance of 45 degrees. Let's say for first 1 second it has traveled 45 degrees, or rather it has traversed 45 degrees. For the next 1 second again, we observe that it has moved by an angle of 45 degrees. Again for the next second, we see that it has again traveled 45 degrees. So for equal intervals of time, if it is going to travel, or say if it is going to make 45 degrees angles, or same angle rather, then we say this uniform angular velocity. Okay, that's it. Now remember, moving point has got to sort of make linear movement in the uniform sense, and the rotating link has got to travel, or has got to make equal angles in equal intervals of time. So rotating line, you can say, both of them are following sort of an arithmetic progression and uniformly. So that's it. So these are the two conditions, and once these two conditions are satisfied, both of them are uniform, then such a spiral is referred to as an Archimedean spiral. So that was all about it. And there is also a polar form of this Archimedean spiral. Let me go ahead and tell you that. Well, sometimes in some of the competitive examinations, you may be asked that which one of the following represents the polar form of an Archimedean spiral. So in that problem, you have to know this. So it can be written as R is equal to C plus A theta. Now you need to know what R is. Okay, so R is nothing but the position vector, not position vector, but the radius vector. Let's say, where is the eraser gone? Since there is rotation, we always have to take this into account. Radius vector at any given point. C is nothing but the initial radius vector. A is basically a constant, and the importance of A is something which can only be understood in video number 3, that is where we are going to put up tangent and normal. You'll realize that very soon. And finally we have this theta. Theta is nothing but the angle, or the vectorian angle. angle, and it has to be taken in radians always. Remember this. Now guys, let us take an example and let us try to understand the construction process for making an Archimedean spiral for one convolution or for one revolution of the link, you can say. So here is the problem. Draw an Archimedean spiral of one convolution, fine. Given the radial movement of point P during one convolution as 40 millimeters. So that is the max, you can say. And the initial position of P as pole O. So point P initially is coinciding with the pole O. Okay, fine. So it's something like this. Point P coinciding with this pole, right? And this length over here has to be taken as 40 millimeters. Remember. Okay. Now what? That's 40. Now guys, this has to be divided into 8 equal parts, the reason for which will be understood in a short while. So just trust me and go ahead and make 8 divisions of this line. You can follow the line division technique which I had explained in plane scales and diagonal scales, or you can also do 40 has to be, this 40 mm line has to be divided into 8 parts. So 40 divided by 8 is 5 millimeters. So in this case, it's become very simple, okay? Had this been 41 mm or 42 mm, well, it would have been difficult because the answer 41, let's say, divided by 8 would not have been an integer in that case. Okay, so keep the zero of your scale over here and after intervals of 5 millimeters, start placing point. And once you do that, you'll have this way, okay? Now, keep the one leg or the steel end of your compass over here and the pencil end of your compass over here, and then do this, then divide the circle into 8 parts. Now here is the deal. If your circle has to be divided into 8 equal parts, then you have to divide this line into 8 equal parts. In some of the books I have seen, they go for 12 divisions of the circle. That means here you'll see angles of 30 30 and 30, okay? They trisect, I bisect, okay? Now remember this: for 8 divisions of the circle, 8 divisions of the line. For 12 divisions of the circle, 12 divisions of the line. Now 8 divisions is a bit easy, I mean it takes less time, that is why I follow it. You guys can also go ahead and do the same problem by making 12 divisions. Okay, now we are going to give this a clockwise rotation, okay? So this is going to be our point number 0, you can say. This is going to be our point or position 1 of the link, this is position 2 of the link, and so on. That's the final position, which coincides obviously with the initial position 0 and 8. So what's next? Watch this. First red dot, steel end of your compass or your rounder over here at O. Pencil end of your compass on the first red dot, you can say. Rotate it until you reach this link O1. That's position P1 of the moving point. Keep one leg of your compass here at the pole, other leg on the second red dot. Rotate in the clockwise sense until you in some way intersect this O2. It's something like this. That's P2. Third red dot, rotate until you reach O3. That's P3. In the same manner, make the remaining stuff. Keep on doing that. And finally, when you go for this rotation, you are going to end up here only. So you don't have to worry about that. That is going to be point P8. And when you join all these points in proper sequence with the help of a smooth curve, this is exactly what you get. And that's a spiral of one convolution. I hope I'm clear. Okay, so that was all about an Archimedean spiral for one convolution. Now let us take up one more example, and this is going to be two convolutions. Slightly hectic, but you have to deal with it. Okay, so let me read out the problem for you. It goes like this. Construct an Archimedean spiral of two convolutions given the greatest and shortest radii as 84 millimeters. Now guys, in the previous problem, the shortest radii was 0 and the greatest radii was 40 millimeters. But in this case, the shortest radii has to be taken as 12 and the greatest radii has to be taken as 84. This is going to be also simple, but slightly more time consuming, you can say. And here it is. This is 12 OP, smallest radii, shortest radii, and this, from this point until we reach here, that is going to be 84, right? So O0 is 84 and OP is 12. And in that sense, the distance from P to 0 is going to be 84 minus 12. That's, I guess, 72, isn't it? Yeah, Now what? Again, for one convolution, we did how much? 8 parts of the line, of the link. But for two convolutions, we have to go for 16 parts. So what? How can that be achieved? So this is the minimum radii and this is the max radii, you can say. What I'll do is, I need to divide this P0 line into 16 equal parts. Remember, for one convolution, 8 parts, for two convolutions, 16 parts. Now, I'm going to use the line division technique for that. I will randomly draw a line over here at any angle, let's say 45 degrees. And then I'm going to be putting up arcs of equal radii. I have taken it as basically 5 millimeter arcs. So, how many arcs for 16 divisions? 16 arcs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. This final arc has to be joined with the end of the line. So keep your mini drafter lined up along this line. Tighten the screw, bring it over to the 15th point, draw line to the 14th point, draw line. Keep on doing so until all these points have been exhausted. And you'll see automatically this line P0 has been divided into, 16 equal parts. Fine. Now draw a circle. Okay, mark the points, red dots, very important. Draw a circle. With this O0 as the radius, draw a circle. Now, here we are going to give this an anti-clockwise rotation. You can go for clockwise rotation also. But just to give you a different feel, in this case, we'll go for an anti-clockwise rotation. So, the numbering has to be done in the anti-clockwise sense. And let me show you. First of all, let me divide this into 8 equal parts. And this is going to be 0.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and that's it. But that is only for one convolution. Okay, you need to go further. This is going to be 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So, two convolutions done. Let's begin. So, the point initially, this is the shortest radii. So, the point initially is over here. Now, what you need to do is, always you need to keep the steel end of your compass or rounder at O. Always. Okay. And then, pencil end on the first red dot over here, give it an anti-clockwise rotation. This is going to be your point P1. Second red dot until you reach this O2. Third red dot until you reach O3. Let me show you. Fourth red dot until you reach O4. Fifth red dot until you reach O5. Sixth until you reach O6. Seventh until you reach O7, and the 8th red dot, by default is this one. You don't have to make it. It will be a circle, in fact. You don't have to go for it. Okay. Let's move further. Or leave this, you can say. So, let me just mark the points. This is going to be P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7. And guys, this is going to be P8. Don't worry. Let's go for P9. Again, one leg of your compass at the pole, other leg over here, and this is precisely the 9th red dot. So rotate it anti-clockwise until you reach O9, this way. 10th red dot until you reach O10. 11th red dot until you reach O11. 12th until you reach O12. 13th until you reach this O13, this way. And in the same manner, you can keep going. And the 16th red dot is going to coincide with this fellow over here. So finally, let me mark all the points. And this is how we go. That's point P1, P2. That's P1. And this is P2. I won't mark all of them. You can understand them very well. P3, P4, P5, P6, P7. That's P8. It's P9, P10, P11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And this is the final point, 16th. Right? When you join all these points in proper sequence, you get a curve which is popularly known as a spiral, and to be very specific, it's a spiral of two convolution. This is first convolution and this is the second convolution. So guys, that was all from my side for today. I'll come up with another video on logarithmic spiral. Until then, take care, have a nice day, and thanks for watching.